Here comes two!
Thanks, man. Why don't you get a goat or something?
Do I look like a farmer?
Just saying, I mean, like, you could film Jumanji out here.
Yeah. Thanks for coming out, man.
Sorry I don't make more of an effort, but I wouldn't leave you hanging, man.
I appreciate that.
So what happened?
Well, we're driving down the road. Kitty was talking about things.
So my friend Gigi's getting married, and she asked me to be a bridesmaid, and I'm really excited because I've never had the chance of being a bridesmaid before. And she's been telling me about the color scheme for the wedding, and it sounds so pretty. And I've never really thought about the color scheme for my wedding. I think more of a crimson and a white would be my style. I mean, that sounds pretty, right?
Sure.
And she's having a big wedding. Oh my goodness, they're getting this huge church and all of her friends and family are coming. And it's just gonna be a giant blowout. They're even getting caterers, complete with a menu. I don't think I would ever want anything that big. I think just a small chapel or, I mean, even outside in a gazebo during the summer, I think that'd be so pretty, don't you think?
Yeah, that's fine.
They're even going to the Maldives for their honeymoon. I mean, that sounds so pretty, but so expensive. Oh my goodness, I think I would just be perfectly fine with a cabin tucked away in the mountains, sitting by a fireplace. That sounds cozy, right?
Why are you asking?
I'm just asking to ask. You know, making conversation.
Well, we're not getting married, so what does it matter?
Do you love me?
What?
Do you love me?
What kind of question is that?
It's a simple one with a simple answer.
Of course I do.
So do you just think about us in the now?
No.
So you see a future together?
I don't know.
What do you mean you don't know? Which is it?
I don't know, okay?
As soon as we got back, she just got in her car and left.
Damn, that sucks.
I don't know what to do, man.
Well, do you love her?
Yeah.
Well, I mean, go get her. Seems simple.
But there's still the issue about marriage.
Well, did you not think that was going to come up?
I guess so.
Women always want to get married, dude. Like, Penny bought a freaking wedding dress and wore it around the house for a month, and I didn't even catch on. I just thought she bought a cool white dress.
Dinah didn't.
Dinah?
Yep.
You never told me you proposed to her.
That was the single most embarrassing moment in my life. Why would I tell you?
Now you gotta tell me.
So, one evening we were out for a walk.
What a day this has been. What a rare mood I'm in. Why, it's almost like being in love. There's a smile on my face for the whole human race. Why, it's almost like being in love. All the music of life seems to be like a bell that is ringing for me. And from the way that I feel when that bell starts to peal, I would swear I was falling. Swear I was falling. Why, it's almost like being in love. Life seems to be like a bell that is ringing for me. And from the way that I feel, when that bell starts to peal, I would swear I was falling, swear I was falling. Why, it's almost like being in love.
So, did you hear about Bob and Karen?
What's going on with those two?
Well, Karen called the cops on Bob again.
So, how many times does that make this month?
Three, I think.
Drinking again?
As always, Bob the Lush.
Karen the Psycho.
Mm-hmm. Two peas in a pod.
Mm-hmm. Crazies are meant for each other.
For sure.
So, what's going on with this stuff?
You don't like it?
I prefer your cute little baby face.
Yeah, but this is just a work in progress. It'll get longer and more epic, and it'll be great.
It could grow on me.
Perhaps. Remember your purple hair face?
Mm-hmm.
You know how that had to grow on me?
Yeah, but it was awesome.
It was awesome. It just, you know, took me a little bit of time.
Well, I'll give this some time.
All right.
It's a nice day out.
Yeah, a little windy, but it's very beautiful.
It's always nice when we're together. So, do you have something on your mind?
Yeah, I don't know. I've got something I've been wanting to talk to you about. Just been waiting for the right moment.
I need to talk to you about something also.
All right, well. Ladies first.
My boss came to me yesterday and offered me a job, a promotion actually.
That's great.
Yeah, I'll be making $10,000 more a year in salary and finally get my own office.
Great, I'm happy for you.
There's just one catch.
Okay.
I would have to relocate.
To where?
Maxima City. I know this probably isn't something that you want to hear.
No, it's not.
But I've worked really hard to get to this point. I just can't pass it up.
Marry me.
What?
Marry me.
Felix, I...
Look, I'm not asking so you'll just stay. I want you to go. I want to go with you. I want to be with you.
I just don't think this is the right time.
Anna, please. I love you.
I'm sorry. I can't. I just can't.
I just walked away, didn't say anything to her, and hadn't spoken to her since. She was the love of my life, dude, and she broke my heart.
I had no idea.
It's not something I wanted to go around telling everybody.
I mean, you do understand why she said no, right?
I mean, I guess.
Come on, man.
It's all about timing, right?
You are the dumbest smart person I know.
Dude. I would have done anything for her.
And you would have been miserable trying. There is no way you would have survived living in Maxima City.
But I would have tried. That should count for something, right?
Maybe it should have. At the time. But that's over. I mean, what about the woman you're with now? What are you willing to do for her? I mean, I understand where your fear of commitment is coming from. I get it. But you won over Kitty's heart despite her rejecting you numerous times. You treat her with more respect than anybody she's ever had in her life. I mean, she loves you, dude. She is not going anywhere. Unless you want her to.
Do Felix?
Hey, Alice.
Well, this is unexpected.
You did say if I was feeling down to give you a call, so... Here I am.
What's wrong?
I think Kitty may have broke up with me.
That's for sure.
Well, we were kind of having a fight, and then when we got back, she got in her car and left, and now she won't answer my calls.
Sounds like she just needs some space. I'd give it to her. What was the argument about?
It may have had something to do with marriage.
She was talking about marrying you.
No, she was talking about a friend's wedding.
You just really need to start thinking before you speak.
I know.
You ever told her about Dinah?
God, no.
Okay, well, see, there, you might want to do that so she can have a little bit of context behind your irrational behavior.
Am I wrong to feel that way?
No. But eventually you are going to have to move past it.
But she could say no, too, especially now.
Look, she could say no. And that would suck, right? But life would move on. You're never gonna know unless you have that conversation with her.
Do you think I could make it in Maximum City? Is that a no?
No, I mean... I think it would overwhelm you. I mean, I know how you are with crowds, and I mean, shoot, even I get a little overwhelmed at it, and I have a lot more higher tolerance than you do.
But could I make it?
Yeah. I think you could. Why are you asking?
Just figuring some stuff out.
Much as I would love to have you living closer to me, I truly hope you're not using that as an excuse to run away from your problems.
No. Just realizing what I gotta do.
Got a fragrant memory on the breeze. Close my eyes and it's like she's here with me. To be young and wield so much desire, we ran hand in hand into the fire, but found ourselves alone on the other side. Maybe it wasn't really love, but it was quite a ride.
Maybe not all of them.
Despite that, do you think I could make it as a writer?
Where are you going with this?
Just answer the question honestly.
Yes. I 100% believe you can make it as a writer.
I owe you an apology. And an explanation for everything that happened earlier. There's a moment in my past that I've been hanging on to for far too long. For reasons that seem very trivial, but now speak volumes. Something just snapped, and it made me realize everything I need to know about my past, my present, and everything I want in my future. So, Captain McCullough, will you do me the honor of being Mrs. Felix Thompson?
When it's all you want, one can't conceive that it can fall upon so easily. She was like the woman of my dreams, cause it's what I wanted her to be. We create our own reality. Maybe it only flew away, cause I held so tight. Came into my world a radiant smile, and helped to drag me out of my denial. Though at the time I thought I'd lost the dream, it was standing